And that's because that's the first impression, first thing that popped in my second mind before I said those words. Club, bouncing beats and dancing and whatever, but you feel sick around people. And it's not the alcohol or whatever you're doing. You know, you can't blame it on the alcohol. You know, you get a headache and you feel crazy. Or something saying, get out of there, get out of here. I recommend you do, you know. Probably someone's about to blow up or there's a fight about to happen. So shit's about to go down, shots are about to be popped off. Something's on the way. So, or if you're already just a sensitive person and you can just be observe that stuff without letting it affect you, but you can learn how to do that. If you have to be there, you have no choice. If you're a club owner or something and you're stuck there, use that knowledge. Use your knowledge, you know, of the negative vibe, and then counteract it using your own energy. Okay. And you have that power. You can change the energy. Jeremy and I do that all the time, so constantly, and it does work.
Yeah.
You can reverse it. You can reverse the effect. You know, just take it, send another you out, create another you to do your bidding. I know that sounds crazy, but it does. It can happen. Anything and everything is possible in this universe. Create a you that's simply out there sending vibes to everybody at the club and clearing up energy. You're sitting in your chair, but yet the astral you is out there doing bidding, vibes, the suggestion to clear the negative, clear the hate. That's another thing. If there's hatred and you're feeling it, or people about want to kill each other. We speak of this because it's making me think of some people that got killed down in Shaco Bottom that we talked to in the spirit world.
Yeah.
And when we talked to these guys, they said that like it was just negative energy. It was all right at first. People got to drinking and negative vibes took over and fights started happening. Next thing you know, the guns got pulled, came out, and they were dead. This stuff that happened back in the spring, these guys. But also, let's speak for what Cliff said, well, don't get in the wrong car. What did he say? Don't get in the wrong car at the wrong time.
Oh, yeah.
He said some shit like that.
Yeah, don't get in the wrong car at the wrong
time. Wrong car at the wrong
time. Yeah,
because, when he died, he could have used, he didn't know, but I think it was his time, but yet also it didn't have to be either. He could have used, if he was more sensitive to feeling vibes and intuition, something would have told him, these people are the people to deal with, and not this car, not this moment, not this day, That was what Cliff had mentioned. I remember that from back in April when we chatted with him,
I remember that.
But incidentally, Cliff's a cool dude, man. And y'all know him. Call us, so he'll come through and talk again. He's a good dude. So, young, but real open-minded. That's what I like about him. Chatty, open-minded, happy, like that. But, what else can we say about vibes? Main thing is, pay attention to your body. Your physical body can tell you what vibes are going on. Like pay attention to the sudden headache, the nausea. Pay attention to that feeling you get that's making you, pushing you away, making you want to run away from wherever you are. Pay attention to that,
Yeah, exactly. Don't let your inwardness control you, Your outwardness control your inwardness. Try to control yourself, We're addicted to being faulty, We're even addicted to being right for change.
A lot of people are taught in life that psychic knowledge, intuition is fake and it's fraud and all that. It's not. Believe me, it's far from it. And there's not, no certain people are the only ones blessed with that. Everyone's blessed with the ability. That's your It's not just what five senses people have, humans have, they have six.
Yeah.
The sixth sense is that intuitive sense, and everyone has it, and that's not just some movie thing, it's true.
Yeah.
It's absolute fact.
Yeah.
Sixth sense is fact. The fact.
Absolutely.
And, you know, and then you make it work by using it. Put it to the test. Start out by using intuition for the little things. You know, if you feel someone telling you do this, do that, and it comes out of nowhere quickly, the way you get going and turn it on, that switch inside of you to use your intuition all the time again and become psychic again is by starting out. You have to use it.
Yeah.
If you don't take what's given to you in psychic intuitive knowledge and use it, it'll just disappear.
And recognize it. Try to recognize it.
That's right. Recognize it. And use it.
Yeah.
You can't just recognize it but not use it. You use it when you recognize it. Let's say that. Yeah, I know. If you recognize it and know what it is, you're going with it too.
Yeah.
But the next step after that is actually trusting that knowledge, you know, to make your decisions and do things, actually perform actions in physical life, in your mind, in your body, using that knowledge, trusting it. And once you start doing that, man, you watch your life change. And you'll come to rely on that.
Yeah.
You know, that you won't rely on what you hear anymore, what you smell or taste, you know, or what people say to you. Even what friends say to you, it won't matter anymore. It's what you see in your mind that'll start mattering. When someone's talking to you and you're seeing the images and feelings going through you, that's what matters, not the words.
Yeah.
And if the words don't match to what you're feeling, that person's probably lying, you know, or making up something if there's not a match. So,
trust your instincts.
Trust all the instincts. Please do. Because then you'll turn into a great psychic. You'll be there, you know. You'll become more powerful day by day the more you trust it. And that power is so much more satisfying than this fake power. I call it fake. Fake things in this world, like money and all this stuff, and worrying about money and
authority
and what clothes you have, the brand of your shoes. Quit worrying about that and start worrying yourself with your spiritual state.
Yeah.
You know, not whether or not you believe in Christ and ask for repentance and all, but your inner God, the God within you, the spirituality that lives within you. You know, find that. Couple more minutes. We'll wind this one up here. We'll check back with y'all soon here. You know, we have a couple calls we need to return. People called, and we're going to get back with y'all. And then, if you're watching this tonight and we haven't gotten back to you or anyone in particular, trust us. Please be patient. We just got a lot going on. We will get back with you. You know, ASAP. All right. Peace.